Indians have always been interested in cross-cultural references in public spaces. Dharma in India is seen by scholars as continuously evolving and adapting to uphold principles of love and compassion. We also find it reflected in public spaces of India in ancient and medieval times. In this video, we look at the art and architecture of Odisha. As usual, I'll be incorporating some of my paintings, photographs, and videos to describe the landscape. So why am I discussing history? Because as architects, we have to remember we are trying to build something that is useful and can be rooted. You can transfer the fashion of one land to another with the movement of people, but if the structures do not carry a timeless appeal, they turn into ruins. Moreover, ancient Indian art was relentless in its pursuit for truth that is eternal. Having had so much that happened in antiquity, occasionally we have a glimpse of how people lived in prehistoric times when ancient sites are excavated, such as the Harappan, the Mohenjo-Daro sites, and lately the Shishupalagada in Khurda, Odisha. Present-day Odisha was known by many names and has been referred to in Mahabharata, Ramayana, and various Buddhist texts. Our ancestors are deeply connected to the aboriginal tribes such as the Bhuiyas and Gonds. You will be surprised to know that so far there are 106 rock cut art sites found in Odisha. Everyone knows about the conquest of Kalinga by the Mauryan Emperor Ashoka in 261 BC. But Kalinga, long before Ashoka, must have been a mighty power to have resisted him so bravely. In early historical period, the seafaring traders of east coast of India brought prosperity to their people. They used to trade with the Malaysian Peninsula. The Golobai excavations in 1991 and others have thrown light on the Chalcolithic era settlements of Odisha. Here are a few photographs from the Sisupalagada excavations by archaeologist Dr. R.K. Mohanty. It shows the urbanized city of Odisha, which can be dated to much before Ashoka. The traders usually started their journey on Kartik Purnima, the 15th lunar day on the month of Kartik, which coincided with everything auspicious. A correlation to present times that I want to make here is of the Boita Vandana Utsav that is celebrated on Kartik Purnima by the Odias. This painting shows the scenario of early morning before dawn on festival day, where boats with lights light up the neighborhood water bodies in Odisha till today. The Sadhavas used to start their journey looking at Dhruva Tara in the sky in early mornings. Another festival that is celebrated by the coastal communities of Odisha till today is the Khudurukuni Osha. Young girls pray to goddess Mangala for the safety of their brothers and remember the maritime days of Odisha. Palur and Manikapatna, a port near here, are mentioned by Greek geographer Ptolemy in 150 Common Era, and Chelitalo port near Konark is referred to by Huen Sang in 600 CE. During Ashoka's rule, Kalinga had two political centers, Tosali and Samapa. Then we have record of Chedi dynasty or Mahamegavahana dynasty, which ruled from 250 to 400 Common Era. King Kharavela was the third generation of Mahamegavahana dynasty and established a strong empire in 2nd century. The Hathi Gumpa inscriptions in Brahmi script and sculptural carvings in the Khandagiri and Udayagiri caves of Bhubaneswar reflects upon the socio-economic condition during those times. During Kharavela, the inscriptions clearly mention that all religions were equally treated, even if Kharavela was of the Jaina faith. During the Guptas, many local ruling dynasties took shape. They were the Matharas, Nalas, Vigrahas, Eastern Ganga, the Manas, the Dattas, the Sailodhavas. They all had tribal origins. The Sailodhavas were Shaivas, but equally patronized the Jaina and Vaishnava faiths. The Sarvapuriyas were Vaishnavites, but they built many Shiva temples. The Bhaumakara dynasty originated in the Bhuya tribes. From 600 to 1000 Common Era, there was a gradual regional state formation. The Bhaumakaras ruled over Tosala and Utkala for 200 years, with capital located at Jajpur in 736 Common Era. Their dedication to encourage different sects surpassed all others. Now let's take a look at the Vaital Deula temple built in 775 CE by the Bhaumakaras. The presiding deity of the temple is Goddess Chamunda. It was built in the Koshali Khakara style. This temple has images of Hara Parvati, Ardhanareshwara, Lakulisha, Tantric Mahayana images like Amoghasiddha, Sakta images like Mahisasura Mardini, Saptamatrikas. The overlap and adoration of beliefs in Shaiva, Shakti traditions of Hinduism, Jainism, Buddhism, Ajivikaism is quite prominently displayed in this temple. The religious syncretism of the Bhaumakaras culminated in the Jagannath culture of present-day Odisha. They were followed by Somavansis of Dakshina Kosala in the 11th and 12th century. The Mukteshwara temple was one of the earliest works of Somavansi period, and Percy Brown dates it to 950 CE. The pyramidal roof to the Jagamohana present in the temple was the first of its kind over the conventional two-tier structure. The important feature of the temple is the Torana. The beauty of the moderate height of the temple is enhanced by distinct vertical and horizontal folds in the astellar masonry. Every year, Mukteswar festival is held in its precinct. The old town Bhubaneswar is built around the concept of Ashta Ayatana, eight sacred precincts. Bindusagar comes in the first precinct. The public spaces around the tank are from the 10th to the 13th century. In this painting, Ananta Vasudeva temple is seen on the left, Lingaraja is seen in the middle, and Brahma temple is seen in the far right. The Lingaraja temple was built in the 11th century and is dedicated to Lord Shiva. It was originally constructed by the Somavansi kings, with later additions by the Ganga rulers between 6th and 11th century. Ananta Vasudeva temple was built by Queen Chandrika, daughter of Ananga Bhima Deva III of Eastern Ganga dynasty in the 13th century. So how can I end without mentioning Konark? The Konark temple was built in the 13th century by Narasimha Deva I of Eastern Ganga dynasty. It was built inside the ocean, a temple dedicated to sun god. It was built to be an encyclopedia in stone for future generations. Envisioned as a lavish chariot with ornamental wheels and drawn by seven galloping horses, it has 12 pairs of wheels which represent 12 months of the year, and sculptures in the temple, even in the ruins, are extensive, including mythical beings, birds, animals, and extensive description of social life of people during that time. What we see today are the ruins of its entrance hall. In future episodes, I'll be discussing many significant and interesting details of Kalinga architecture. Now, let's discuss Jagannath Temple. The Jagannatha Stuti, written by Adi Sankaracharya, is treasured in all Odia households. Jagannath Swami Nayana Pathagami Bhavatume. Jagannath temple was built between 1085 and 1223 Common Era. Before I delve into the historic facts, I have to mention the story of Lord Jagannath's idol. It is believed that after mistakenly killing Lord Krishna and performing his last rites, Jarasavara picked up some mortal remains of Krishna and settled down near Kantilo in Kalinga. Many generations passed and King Indradyumna later acquired the idol from Vishwavasu, the Chasavara chief. Now, speaking with reference to an article by Manoj Das, He says, in present day history, all sects of Sanatana Dharma claim Lord Jagannath. During Buddhist influence under early Bhaumakaras, Sri Jagannath was Gautama Buddha, Balabhadra was Sangha, and Devi Subhadra was Dharma. During the time of Kharavela, Jagannath is revered as a Jaina deity. The Madala Panji states that King Yayati Kesari, the Somavansi king, built the first Jagannath temple at its present location. The imperial Ganga inscriptions give credit to Anantavarman Chodaganga Deva. Now, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramanujacharya have also emphasized the significance of Jagannath Dham. Adi Sankaracharya, in the beginning of 9th century, established Puri as one of his dhamas. The most fascinating event in Odia lives related to Jagannath temple is the yearly Ratha Yatra. When the three deities, they come out on chariots, the chariots are constructed over 42 days and millions of people gather. It's a sight like no other. But Odisha's independence ended in 1568 after Mukunda Deva. During the Mughal and British periods, there was proliferation of the zamindari system. Even Sanskrit texts were denied to the local population. But the faith of the impoverished people never shattered. They were always graced by the writings of the saint poets, the bhakti poets, the Panchasakhas of the 16th century. Sarala Das is one among the Panchasakhas of Odisha. In this painting, we see the Birata Rupa. In Sarala Das's Mahabharata, he describes a forest scene of Arjuna meeting the Birata Rupa of Lord Krishna. Arjuna is scared at first, but recognizes his friend Krishna looking at the chakra in his hand. In the 19th century, poets like Bhima Bhoi and many more sustained the people's spiritual aspirations. In this painting, I have tried to add visual motives to one of his writings. Oloto brukhe kheluchi lotoni para suta kati ponjuri re nopode dhara. In this poem, the pigeon is the metaphor for the soul. Our body is compared to the upside down tree. The soul's relationship or attachment to the body is but for a while. It's not eternal. So Bhima Bhoi is urging people to look beyond their circumstances and have spiritual goals. For the people of Odisha, saints like Bhima Bhoi have enriched the Odia tradition, reminding us again and again of our relationship with Parabrahma.
Bye.